Good morning, everyone. It's your English class, and today we are going to study our first chapter of Unit 2, The Last Leaf. Half part of this chapter we studied in our previous class, and rest of part we are going to study now. So let's start. So in previous two pages, like we studied that there were two girls. One name was Sue and the second name was Jonesy. So they both were artists. They both were painters. So Jonesy got illness, that is pneumonia. And she got the fancy that she will not get well and she will die soon. And she just kept looking out of the window and on a wall out of the window, there was a ivy vine and there were some leaves. And Jonesy got fancy that with the leaf, she will die. When last leaf will fall, I will also die. And she got this fancy. Right. And there was another painter. That name is Behrman. That was old man. So regarding this, we studied in a previous class, and now we have come on the third page of this chapter. So some internal question also we did in a previous class, right? So we have come on this page. So let's study. Please wait. Yes. Sue found Behrman in his dimly lighted den. So what happens? Sue went to call the Behrman because Behrman was also a painter and he was old man and he was quite helpful. So Behrman was in house and light was quite dim there. And den is called in Hindi, that's a gufa. So that was called house, that is a den. She told of Jonesy's fancy. So she told to Behrman about the Jonesy's imagination regarding falling the leaves. How she feared she would indeed light and fragile as a leaf herself float away when her slight hold upon the world grew weaker. Then Sue told to Behrman that she is getting weak and she will also leave the hold on this world, and like a leaf she will also float away, means she will die. The old Behrman shouted his contempt and derision for such idiotic imagination. So he became very like angry on such type of idiotic imagination. He said that this is not good, so that's a quite idiotic imagination. Was he cried, is there people in the world meet the foolishness to die because leaves they drop off from the confounded vine? I have not heard of such a thing. Why do you allow that silly business to come in the mind of her? Oh, dot poor little Miss Jonesy. So now you can observe that these lines, you can see that English is not proper. So such type of English is spoken by any native speaker who is not well educated. Just because of nativeness, he can speak or she can speak. So we can say that's a broken English, so not complete English. So in local dialect or in his own self-made English, he is saying these all the things he is saying. Like, I can't believe that such type of people are there in this cosmos, in this world, who can believe on such type of imagination. Then he says to Sue that you should not allow such type of bitterness or imagination in her mind. So even he also says that he's a quite poor Jonesy, but like a little Miss Jonesy. He says like that. Then she's very ill and weak, said Sue, and the fever has left her mind morbid and full of strange fancies. Morbid means such type of illness. Sue says to Behrman that she has become quite weak and quite ill, and because of this illness, she had got such type of fancy and such type of disease. "That's just like a woman," yelled Behrman. "Got this is not any place in which one go got as Miss Jonesy shall lie sick. Someday I will paint a masterpiece and we shall all go away gorgeous." So again, in the broken English, the Behrman says that she's just like a poor woman, and there is no any place in where such type of imagination will stay. And then he says that I will paint a masterpiece, then we'll go away from this. Like this, that Behrman says that. Then Jonesy was sleeping when they went upstairs. When they went upstairs means when Sue and Behrman went upstairs, that time Jonesy was sleeping. Sue pulled the shadow down to window sill and motioned Behrman into the other. Right after that, he shut down the window sill and motion Behrman means like motion means like to make any signal or to call someone. So Behrman was called into the other room. In there, they peered out the window fearfully at the ivy vine. So they saw the ivy vine. Then they looked at each other for a moment without speaking. They looked towards each other without speaking. A persistent cold rain was falling. Continuous rain was going on, mingled with snow, and snow was mixed there. Behrman, in his old blue shirt, took his seat on a upturned kettle. So there was a kettle that was upturned, many yani ki ulti rakhi hona. So Behrman was Behrman sat there. When Sue awoke next morning, she found Jonesy with dull, wide open eyes staring at the drone sheet. So sheet was drawn that time when Sue woke up, and she found that Jonesy was trying to look out of the window. "Put it up. I want to see," she ordered in whisper. So when the Jonesy saw that window is closed, then she said that, "Put it up. I want to see what's outside. What's about those leaves?" Wearily, she obeyed. Means like without, willing. She obeyed this. Means that she went there to open that window. But lo, after the beating rain and fierce gust of wind that had endured through the night. Endured means like stay for a long time. Durable, we can say that. So like this, like observe that the last leaf was there, and there was a much rain, and even the wind was blowing also, but the last leaf was there. There yet stood out against the brick wall on ivy leaf. Means ivy leaf was there. It was the last one on the vine. So it was the last one. Still dark green near its stem. So it was the color of that leaf was green. With its shattered edges. Shattered means you can say a zigzag. So you can say the leaf of edges are zigzag. So shattered edges tinted with yellow. So yellow color was also there. It hung bravely from the branch some 20 feet above the ground. So it was hung just approximate 20 feet above the ground. Next, "It is the last one," said Jonesy. Jonesy said that it is the last leaf. "I thought it would surely fall during the night." So she says that, "I thought about this leaf, it would fall down during the night. I heard the wind, it will fall today, and I shall die at the same time." So she says that, "I heard the wind and I thought that it will fall down and I will also die with the last leaf." "Dear, dear," said Sue, leaning her worn face down to the pillow, "think of me. If you won't think of yourself, what would I do?" Then Sue says to her, "Please think about me, dear." if you can't think about you, please think about me. What will happen with me if you think about like this? So Sue says like this. The day wore away, and even through the twilight, they could see the lone ivy leaf clinging to its stem against the wall. So author says that even day was passed in the twilight, in the night also, that leaf could be seen on the against that wall. When the coming of the night, the north wind was again loosed, while the rain beat against the window. So in the night, wind was blowing, and even the rain was also going on, right? When it was light enough, Jonesy merciless commanded that the shed be raised. When the light was enough, Jonesy said that the shed be raised, means open the window. The ivy leaf was still there. The next morning when they saw that ivy leaf was still there, Jonesy lay for a long time looking at it. Then she called Sue, who was stirring chicken broth over the gas stove. So Jonesy just kept looking that leaf, and after some time, like, she called to Sue, and she was just making chicken soup, chicken broth. She was making that, and she called to Sue. "I have been a bad girl, Sue," said Jonesy. Jonesy said to Sue, "I was a bad girl. I should not be like this. Something has made that the last leaf stay there to show me how wicked I was." Then Jonesy said that something happened with this last leaf, and just because of this last leaf, I have to think that something went wrong with me. "It is a sin to want to die. You may bring me a little broth now, and now bring me." Then Jonesy says that it is very bad. It is sin. Sin means pap. "It is sin to want to die." Means like, I was thinking like this, like I will die soon. So this was sin. This was bad. "And now please bring me broth," means that soup, bring me for me. "And now bring me," come on the next page. So dear students, some difficult words are there. Let's understand these words. Derision. Derision means scorn. Ridicule means hasya parat. Koi chiz aisi ho, isko dekhe hasi aaye. That's a scorn, ridicule, and derision. Next, endured. Endured means lasted, means durable. Next, saturated. Saturated means jagged, means jig-jag ki kisi tarah ki edges ho ya kuch aur banavat ho. That is called saturated. Okay, please wait. Let me take your attendance. Please stay connected. Wait, please. Okay, so now start. Then she says that, "No, bring me a hand mirror first, and I will sit up and watch you cook." Then Jonesy says that, "First of all, bring me a hand mirror, and I will sit up and I will watch you cook," means I will watch you when you will cook. An hour later, she said, "Sue, someday I hope to paint the Bay of Naples." After 1 hour, Jonesy says to Sue, before getting illness, I had hoped to paint a Bay of Naples. The doctor came in the afternoon, and Sue had an excuse to go into the hallway as he left. So when the doctor came to check the Jonesy, and after that, Sue went in the hallway to ask the health of Jonesy to doctor. "Even chances," said the doctor, taking Sue's thin shaking hand in his hand. doctor said that now chances are even, means like good chances are there. With good nursing, you'll win. Means he doctor says that, like with the good nursing, if you care her, then you will win. Means like she will get well. Now I must see another case downstairs, Behrman, some kind of an artist. And doctor says that now I have to go. I have to check. I have to see another case. That person is Behrman. That is also an artist. I believe pneumonia too. Then doctor says that I think he has also got pneumonia. He is an old weak man and attack is acute. Then doctor says that he is old man, he is a weak man, but attack is acute. There is no hope for him, but he goes to the hospital today to be made more comfortable. Doctor says that there are very less hope for that that bear man, and now he has brought to the hospital. The next day, doctor said to Sue, she is out of danger. You won. The next day, again, when doctor came there, then doctor told to Sue that now Jones is out of danger. Now you have won. Your nutrition and care now. That's all. That afternoon, Sue came to the bed where Jonesy lay and put one arm around her. Doctor said that just you have to care and that she will be fine. That afternoon, Sue came to the bed where Jonesy lay and put one arm around her. I have something to tell you, she said. Mr. Behrman died pneumonia today in the hospital. Then Sue says to Jonesy that I want to let you know something about the Behrman, and today Behrman died just because of pneumonia in the hospital. He was ill only 2 days. So Sue says that he was ill just for last 2 days. The janitor means watchman or gatekeeper or doorkeeper, caretaker, we can say. So the janitor found him in his room downstairs, helpless with a pain. The janitor found him. He was in a pain. His shoes and clothing were wet through the icy cold. So in the icy cold, his clothes were wet, means like his clothes were wet badly. Ice was also there. They couldn't imagine where he had gone on such a dreadful night. So like they can't imagine that he went somewhere in the night. Then they found a lantern still lighted and ladder that had been dragged from its place. And they said that lantern they got and ladder means CDN jo hoti hai, that is also good. Some scattered brushes and some scattered means spreaded brushes were there, and a palette with green and yellow colors mixed on it. A palette bhi thi wahan pe, iske andar green or yellow color thi on it. And look out of the window. Then Sue says to Jonesy, please look out of the window. Dear, at the last ivy leaf on the wall. And look at the last ivy leaf on the wall. Sue says to Jonesy like this. Didn't you wonder why it never fluttered or moved when the wind blew? So Sue says to Jonesy, didn't like, were you not surprised regarding these leaf? That leaf did not flutter in fadfadana and move when the wind blew. Oh, darling, it's Behrman's masterpiece. He painted it there the last night that the last leaf fell. So Sue says that is a masterpiece. This is not real leaf. That leaf was painted by the Behrman last night when the leaf fell down, and he painted this leaf just to make you get well. Okay, so ultimately we have come to know that was not the real leaf, that was the artificial leaf, and that was the masterpiece made by that Behrman artist, right? So this is all about this chapter, this story. Now we need to understand the question answer. So janitor, this I have told you, doorkeeper, caretaker, or we can say watchman. Right. Now reading, complete the flow chart of sequence to show how Behrman got around to creating his masterpiece. So these books you have to study, and these like information is half not completed. So you need to complete this information. Like John C and Sue open a studio together. What will come after this? The doctor told Sue that John C had given up on the life. So these boxes we have to fill, and I have done the answer for you. So these are the difficult words which I have already told you. So let's come on the flow chart directly. So this I have done for you. John C and Sue opened a studio together after meeting at a 8th Street Dolmenico, right? So this we have filled. Now, the same way you have to write in your notebook. The doctor told Sue that John C had given up on life and was waiting for her demise. A demise means like death. So doctor told to John C, told to Sue that John C has lost the hope of living. Now she is waiting for her death. Third, he found out that John C had decided that she would die when the last leaf fell from the ivy. So Behrman decided that he would paint the last leaf on the floor. So Behrman found that now she has made the fancy. As the last leaf fall down, she will die. Then Behrman decided that he will paint the last leaf on the floor. Next box. John C realized that she had been a bad girl because Behrman had risked his life in order to paint the last leaf so that she recovers. John C realized that like she had been a bad girl. She was a bad girl. Why? Because of her just getting well, Behrman took the risk of his life to paint that last leaf. Next box. The doctor went to check on Behrman, who had contracted pneumonia. Contracted mean getting illness. Contracted pneumonia as he had gone out in the cold to paint the last leaf. So doctor got it that Behrman got the pneumonia and who went to paint the last leaf. Next, sixth box. The doctor told Sue that care and nutrition had done the trick for John C, and she was out of danger now. And he also told her that Behrman had contracted pneumonia and would not survive. So doctor told to like John C, now you need to just care, and like even like she is out of danger. And doctor also told that Behrman got the illness like pneumonia. Sue told John C that Mr. Behrman had painted the last leaf on the ivy in order to save her life. So Sue told to John C that Behrman painted that last leaf on the ivy. Okay. So in this way, you have to complete these boxes. Clear? Now please come on the next question, B question. Choose the right options to answer these questions. Who was the cold stranger who talked about the colony in November? So dear friends, options I haven't written. I have just written the answers, as you can see that. So options are not written here. So options you can see in your book. Clear? So directly answers I have written. So here pneumonia will come. Next, what is the one thing that John C really wants to paint? That was answer was that Bay of Naples. So Bay of Naples, John C wanted to paint. Next question. Read these sentences from the text and answer the question that follow. First, but when my patient begins to count the carriages in her funeral procession, I subtract 50% from the curative powder of medicine. Who is the speaker? Means who said these lines? So the doctor is speaker of these lines. Doctor said these lines. Next, who is the patient? So we know that John C is the patient. Third question, is that literally what the patient was doing? क्या वो literary था जो patient कर रहा था? Means line is that, but when my patient begins to count, जब मेरे patient शुरू कर देते हैं count करना, carriages मतलब रथ गाड़ियां इन हर फ्यूनल प्रोसेशन, यानी कि अपनी मृत्यु का जो प्रोसेशन होता है, जो अंतिम संस्कार का प्रोसेशन होता है, प्रोग्राम होता है, उसमें जब वो गाड़ियां गिनना शुरू कर देते हैं तो मैं अपनी मेडिसिन की जो क्यूरेटिव पाउडर है उसको घटा देता हूँ। क्या ये लिटरेरी है? क्या जो लिखा गया वही डॉक्टर या स्पीकर कहना चाह रहे हैं? सो आंसर इज नोट, ऐसा नहीं है। वो ये कहना चाह रहा है कि वो अपने उल्टी गिनती स्टार्ट कर देते हैं, यानी कि उनको लगता है कि अब वो मरने वाला है। तो इसका ये अल्टीमेट मीनिंग है, राइट? यानी कि जो बात कही गई है वो मीनिंग नहीं है, उनसे जो अर्थ निकलता है वो मीनिंग है। सो वी कैन से हियर नो इट इज जस्ट अ फिगर ऑफ स्पीच। ओके, नेक्स्ट। जोनसी ले स्केयरली मेकिंग अ रिपल अंडर द बेड क्लोथ्स विद हर फेस टुवर्ड्स द विंडो। What is meant by scarcely making a ripple under the bedclothes? So ripple means wave, कोई wave करना, कुछ हिलना डुलना। So scarcely means लगभग ना के बराबर, मुश्किल से। So we can say here the words signify that Jonesy barely moved। तो ये words signify करते हैं कि वो मुश्किल से move करती थी, हिलती डुलती थी। Next, why was she looking out of the window? We have to tell the reason of looking out of the window. So answer we can write here, she was counting the leaves of ivy vine as they fell one by one. She was just counting the leaves. Okay, next question number 3. I want to turn loose my hold on everything and go sailing down, down, just like one of those poor tired leaves. Who says this? So who says this line? So we know that Jonesy is speaker of these lines. Jonesy spoke these lines. Okay. Next, what does the speaker mean by go sailing down and down? So a speaker means that the speaker is referring to her eventual death. यानी कि जो death उसकी आने वाली है, वो उस death के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं। यानी जिस तरह कोई चीज जाती है sail करके नीचे, तो कहता है कि मेरी भी मृत्यु उसी तरह आने वाली। Next question, why are the leaves tired? So tired means क्या होता है? थका होना, exhausted. So why the leaves are tired? So we can say here the leaves are old and almost dead leaves. So these leaves were old and almost dead. So they are spoken of as if they are tired. So इसलिए कहा गया मानो वो tired हो, right? Next, D part, think and answer. Why did Behrman act as a model for artists in a neighborhood? So why did the Behrman acted as a model for the artist in the neighborhood? Reason we have to tell. So answer we can write here. Behrman acted as a model for the artist so that he could earn enough money to support himself. So he was not very good artist, means according to the people. So that time, that's why just for earning the money, he used to be the model of young artist, right? Second question, the author introduced Behrman as a fierce little old man. Fierce means like frightening, like we can say wild. How is this character trait illustrated in the story? So answer we can write here, Behrman is a man with a strong will. तो बहरमैन एक ऐसा व्यक्ति था जिसकी विल थी, इच्छा थी, इच्छा शक्ति जो थी वो स्ट्रॉन्ग थी। टू सेव जोनसीज लाइफ ही वेंट आउट इन द कोल्ड टू पेंट अ लीफ नियर द वाइन सो दैट जोनसी रीगेन्स हर होप। सो बाय दिस वी कैन से लाइक हिज विल वाज स्ट्रॉन्ग, दैट्स व्हाई ही वेंट आउट इन द रेन एंड ही पेंटेड अ लास्ट लीफ, दैट वाज द मास्टरपीस, एंड इन दिस वे हिज कैरेक्टर वाज शोन। Question number 3, why is the story called The Last Leaf? Can you think of another title for the story? So we can write the answer. The story is called The Last Leaf as it is the painting of the last leaf of vine that helps Jonesy recover from her illness. The story name is Last Leaf. You know that why this name was kept? Because last leaf was painted to save the girl, means to save the Jonesy. That's why title is suitable. Secondly, we can say sacrifice can be another possible title for the story. Sacrifice means balidan karna. That can also be second title of this story because Behrman sacrificed in this story, right? Next, E, discuss in detail. Value-based question. Question is that Jonesy recovered her death as soon as she regained her hopes for life and began to eat. Discuss. So Jonesy recovered her health as he regained the hope for life. Okay, so we have to discuss. So answer we can write here, Jonesy recovered easily after she regained her hopes. This is so because our health depends almost directly on how we perceive the things around us, how we react to them and how we feel. If we keep a positive attitude about everything, the chances of recovery becomes much greater. So basically we want to say here, many illness are there. Almost everything depends on our attitude. If we think positively, then positive things start happening. And if we think negative, so negative things start happening. Okay. Question number two, is there a lesson for us in the way Behrman risked his life to save Jonesy's? So we have to tell that how the Behrman took the risk of his life to save the Jonesy. So what do we understand by this chapter? So answer we can write here. Yes, there is a lesson that we learn from the story. Behrman was an old man who risked his life to save a young girl's life. While Behrman was a failure when it came to art, he knew that Jonesy had potential and he therefore acted the way he did to give Jonesy a chance to work on her. One line is also left, potential and became a great artist. So yes, he took the chance to save the life of Jonesy, and he knew that he was failing art and Jonesy and Sue had good potential, good chances to become a good artist. That's why he took the risk of his life. So this paragraph also you have to learn and write, and I will make you understand this paragraph in your next class. Okay. Otherwise, we have time, so I can explain. Okay, 5 minutes we have, so I can explain. Okay, so this paragraph you have to write, that is written on page number 34. So paragraph you have to written regarding the music. Some instructions are written in your book. So those instructions you can read. Now I explain the paragraph. So paragraph, as you know, that is a short piece of writing. So let's understand the paragraph. Writing a paragraph. Music has been used as a means to help people recover for several centuries. So by the music, we can get the recovery from the several centuries. In ancient Greece, means we are talking about the ancient Greece, Apollo was worshipped as a god. So Apollo was the god and a god of music and medicine. So he was the god of music and medicine. The two fields have since then moved hand in hand. So these two fields went together. Music therapy is performed by professionals all over the world. So music therapy is also performed by the professional over the world. It focuses on all aspects of human body, from physical aspect of emotional, mental, social, spiritual aspects. So it gives the effect of all human body, either that is emotional or mental or social or spiritual. Music has shown to affect the physical and mental well-being of patients and has often helped speed up the recovery. By the music, we can speed up the recovery and we can get the good health. Music therapy also improves cognitive and motor skills. Cognitive means related to understanding. Motor means related to getting physical ability by getting experience. Okay. And is also used by psychiatrists to treat various disorder or even depression. So psychiatrists also use music therapy regarding the depression or disorders. Music has proved to be a very helpful means of treating patients. So by the music, we can treat the patients, right? In the next class, we will read out this chapter. Now, you have 2 minutes if you want to ask any question regarding